Lovely, Serene Dream here with another Philomia and general energy reading. And if you're new to my channel, this reading can apply whenever you find it. It is timeless. It can resonate with you for the day, the week, the month, or even the year. But do keep in mind, because it is a general reading, it's not going to resonate with everyone. So only take what resonates, leave what does not. Reverse the messages if that's how it fits your situation. If you would like to check out your monthly zodiac readings or your general forecast for the rest of the year, or your love forecast for the rest of the year, you can do so at the Vimeo links found in the description box. If you'd like to book a personal reading with me, the link to my website can be found in the description box as well. And if you'd like to receive guidance, you can follow me on Instagram at Serene Dream Things. And let's go ahead and get into your messages for this time. I kept seeing the number 21. I kept hearing, right before this reading, I heard the lyrics, 21, can you do something for me? And I was seeing the number 21. So I feel that 21 could have some significance to whoever this reading resonates with. You can be born on the 21st, someone that you're involved with, that's around in your life, can be born on the 21st, or something could be happening on the 21st of the month whenever you're watching this. I'm also getting something about legal. But what I'm getting from that, not like, I know that that's like the legal drinking age in America, but I'm getting that something could be, yeah, I feel like something is becoming official. Official, possibly in a legal way. But let me channel some more to see what else comes out, and maybe we can make more sense of that message. Yeah, I'm getting like ironclad. Like there's something that is being solidified, something that is, it has a legal binding to it, or there's like, it's just very official. I do feel like it's a legal binding to whatever this is, because I heard ironclad. I got ironclad as a message. So this is some sort of contract that you are going into. I'm hearing this month that is, I feel like it's going to be a good move for you. For some of you, this is career related. So you're signing some sort of contract. I'm hearing a bonus. Some of you could be receiving some sort of, bonus for like a promotion, or like you, if you're starting a new career or a new job, it's like you're signing on for the job, but they're like giving you something extra and putting it into your contract that you receive, like, you know, X amount of dollars at the, like, some sort of bonus by the end of the year. I feel like it's something extra that's being added into the contract just for you. It's like a reward. Like, this is a spiritual reward, but if this is a job, it's like they're giving it to you as like an incentive for you to sign on for this. And so you could have negotiated this for a while. You could have said, okay, like, I'll take this. Unlike, it could have been like a company or some person that was trying to recruit you to join on to their team, join on in their company. And they've considered you, like, they recruited you, they sought you out because they thought you an asset. And so you coming in with that leverage, you weren't just going to sign on to just anything. You felt like, okay, well, let me finesse this a little bit. Let me see what else I can get out of this. Like, this is, this offer, the standard offer was great, but you're like, you know, maybe I can get a little more. And I feel like you sat at that table, you negotiated, and you're getting that little, like, not just a little more. I feel like you're getting a lot more, because you kept, I feel like when you were suggesting things to add to the offer, they were agreeing and you kept pushing. You're like, okay, well, if you're good with that, like, how about, you know, two bonuses at the end of the year? How about, you know, I get like a promotion at the end of 2 years, or a title bump? You know, it's just, I'm getting all kind of messages here, but it's like you negotiate, like you sat at a table, either literally or figuratively, and you negotiated back and forth until you got everything you wanted. So now you're signing on that dotted line in this contract, like you're locked in. They can't change it. It's ironclad. It's legally binding. So everything that you ask for, they're required to give it to you. And I feel like you could have been, it could have been very, like, it could have been someone who was trying to push back, but they knew that if they push back on these requests, that you were going to walk. And they just felt like they could not afford it because you were just such a valuable asset. If this could even be a job that you've been at for a while and maybe you thought about quitting and the employer was like, no, we can't lose you. You're way too valuable. And you're like, you know what? But if you want me to stay, these are my terms. And so they're giving you everything, like they're meeting all your terms. But either way, whether this is a new job offer, career offer, or you being courted to stay where you are, like you're being I'm just gonna say you're being begged to remain at the job that you are, you're getting what you want. And like I said, you're locked into the contracts. So no matter how much they hate what they're giving you or how much it's like it's gonna feel like it's hurting them to give you so much, there's nothing they can do about it now once you sign on that dotted line. And you are gonna sign on that dotted line. Another thing that was coming into me was prenup. So for some of you, this could be a marriage that is happening, and maybe you all are negotiating the prenup. And I feel like if this is a prenup, I feel like it's a very generous offer to you. So should this marriage end for any reason, I know that's not something that people like to go into a marriage thinking about, but in the case that this marriage ends, I feel like you would be set up nicely, because this prenup, like I said, is very generous toward you. Like, you get more than enough. I'm hearing very cushy life. I feel that it's like if this is to do with the marriage, I feel that you all are very logical people. Like, you're in love and you have every intention on making this marriage last, but the both of you are also very logical people. So you decided that you're going to have that hard conversation about the prenup. And I feel like you sat down and you both determined what was fair between the both of you. I don't feel like you're setting this up in a way where one person feels robbed. I feel like both people are very happy with the terms. But I definitely feel like, because I'm reading for the energy that's watching this, you would end up being very... It's a generous offer for you. But I feel like it's also like it's a break for the person as well. Like, it works out for both of you. I don't feel like anybody would be hurting with these terms. I'm also getting a message about something opening up for you. It's like if this is not about like a legally binding contract, I feel like you're going into something, like you're going into a whole new life that's about to open so many doors for you. And it's like once you place your feet into this new territory that is this new life, it's official. So it may not be official in the legal sense, but it's like once you go into this new life, once you just step into, like, past this threshold, it's like there's no turning back. And what you're about to see and what you're about to experience is going to far exceed anything that you've seen or experienced in your past. Like, there are things that you probably thought you enjoyed before. There are probably things you thought you wanted before. But, like, what you're seeing now, what you're experiencing now, you're like, wow, this is more than I could have ever conjured up in my mind. Like, this is past manifestation. The life you're going into, what you're seeing, what you're experiencing, this is life like you've never imagined it to be before. And I feel like it comes with a lot. But also, I'm hearing heavy is the head that wears the crown. So with all of these blessings comes added responsibility. There is going to be times where you're going to be tested, because I'm hearing your crown is going to be tested. So what I'm getting from that is you're going to have people who are going to be testing you. I'm hearing testing your loyalty, testing your strength. And I feel like they're just that, they're tests. I don't feel like they're anything permanent, but I do feel like there's going to be people, like circumstances and people who come in to poke you to see like if you have what it takes to like sit on this throne, if you have what it takes to like be in this position, to wear this crown. I do feel like you might be pushed to a point that you almost feel like breaking, but I don't feel like you will. It's what I get mainly from this, if I'm just being frank, is that you're going to encounter, like, with this, with all these blessings, it's going to be a lot of haters. So you're going to have a lot of people who are going to be around. They don't like you. They don't like what you have. They're jealous of what you have, if I'm being honest. And I feel like at first, the hate may get to you. Like, you may be a really sensitive person who's not used to people looking at you in this way or, like, treating you in this way. But you have to remember that the way they're treating you, the way they're coming at you, it's not really about you. It's about themselves and how they feel inside. And I feel like you're going to have to come to terms with that not everybody is going to like you. Not everybody is going to clap for you. You may even have a smaller circle than you've ever had in your life, because you may even start to see people who have been around you for years starting to like treat you like an enemy, or like show their jealous head is going to start to rear. And you're going to have to cut those people off, and it may hurt you. I'm not even going to lie. It may really hurt you to see like how many people are counting on your downfall or like against you and not happy for you. And it could be people who have seen like all that you've gone through up until this point, like how much hardship you had, how many disappointments and failures you've had up until now, and you're finally winning. But it's like for those people who saw you in those states, it's like they have amnesia now, and they could just, all they see is that you're in this position that they envy, and they're just like, you don't deserve this. And you might start to allow their talk to penetrate your, you know, your head, and you might start to think like, do I deserve this? You might even start to like wonder, should you just give it up? Like, should you forfeit the crown or forfeit these blessings? Don't do that. Everything you have, like, you work for this, you earn this. Don't let anybody tell you you don't deserve to be here, that you don't deserve to have what you're about to have. That's just like, it's test, as I pick up before, you're being tested. But these are real life people who are going to be feeling this way, and you're going to have to learn how to protect your space from enemies. And like I said, you might be a little surprised to find that some of those enemies are people who have been around in your circle for years. But yeah, they're not going to be, it's going to be a number of people who are not happy for you, but you have to learn how to be happy for yourself. And whatever you have to do to protect that happiness, protect your sanity through all this dissension and hate that you're getting, do that. Don't feel guilty about pulling back. Don't feel guilty about telling people no, because you might have people around who are like hating on you and at the same time coming around with their hand out like, hey, can I have this? And you have to learn how to just say no, you know, because it's like they're going to show you who they are. And especially those people who show you that they are not for you, don't feel guilty about not giving them a handout. They don't deserve it. They haven't worked for it. They can't even do the smallest thing and be happy for you. That's like the least you can do, you know, as a person, is just to be happy for others. And they can't even do that. So why do they think they deserve any part of your blessings? Some of you are going to have to physically separate yourself from these people. So some of you could be moving away to a new town, a new place that is very unfamiliar to you, but I feel like you're going to thrive in it. I feel like you're going to, like, if you do end up moving away, I feel like you're going to have so much peace in the place that you're going to. Like, this place is going to fit you, and I feel like it's going to give you, like, the peace that you've always longed for but never had. And you're going to have everything you need there and a little more. I also feel like you're going to be understood where you're going. So while there could be people around you who are going to be falling off because they're haters, I feel like you're going to be going toward like people who do understand you, who you do get along with, who are like you. I'm hearing who you gel with. And this is going to be like your new circle, your new tribe. Some of you are probably going to be forming like a brand new family, because I'm getting like a lot of family energy, sadly. You could have like family members who were not happy for you, and it's going to break your heart to find that you have to separate yourself from them and like go build your own family, whether that be through, you know, getting married, having children, or it could even be just having like, you know, meeting new people and those friends becoming family. So they're like your family. But yeah, and I feel like you're going to spend like, make memories with these people, like, you know, spend holidays with them. Like everything that you would do with the family, I feel like you're going to do with these new people, whether they be friends or like a family you're creating, you know, through marriage or whatever. This could even be like, if you end up in a partnership with somebody, you might end up taking to their family. Like their family might become your family. You might find that you are closer and more understood and more loved and accepted by their family rather than yours. I just keep getting toxic. You're going to have to move away from toxic energy. And this is not going to feel good, because you really thought that, like I said, you're going to be able to see the face, the true face of people who have been around you for years. And you're going to be shocked to see how many, or at least it may not be a lot of people, but I feel like it's some, if it's not multiple people, I feel like there's one person in particular that's really going to break your heart. Because you really thought that when it all came down to it, this person would have your back, that they would be happy for you. But yeah, I'm hearing this song, We Go a Long Way Back. So this is someone who has been in your life for years. This could be like a best friend, like I said, a family member. Someone who's just, they saw you go through a lot. They grew up with you. They saw you grow. They saw you go through the ups and the downs in life. And they could have even been there for you in the past through things you've gone through. But it's something about this blessing is much too great that they can't hide their hate for you anymore. They're really, I feel like they've always been jealous of you. But because you weren't in like a position that they truly envied, maybe you were even in a place that they felt like, okay, they didn't like you, but they feel like, okay, well, at least I have more than them. Like I have, you know, they could have been like in secret competition. Like I have a better car, or I have more money, or I have a nicer place, or I have a nicer partner. Like I have a partner, they don't, or, you know, my partner's, you know, more successful than theirs. And, you know, or, this person could have just felt like they were more well off in some way than you. So although they were still jealous of you, although they may have had more, or they were in like some sort of position that was higher than you, where you, or maybe you even depended on them in some way. And while that was the case, they were jealous of you. And it was because of what you held inside, the energy you possessed. So I feel like you really rode for them, like you really looked at them as somebody who was there for you because of the way they were helping you, the way they were there for you when you were down. But now that you've like surpassed them to a point that they can't exceed, like they can't even try to be in competition with you because they're never going to beat you if they tried, I get like this is when their real face is going to show and it's going to break your heart. I'm very sorry to deliver that news, but you're gonna realize that that life goes on. I'm hearing somebody say, like, I have myself. Some of you may actually start out, like when you break away from this person, you might start out on a journey where you are alone. Like you, it could just be like you yourself, like me, myself, and I. Like I'm getting that kind of energy here. Like, okay, I have myself. And while, you know, that doesn't seem like a lot to a lot of people, that's more than enough for me for now. And along that journey of you just being alone and breaking away from the toxic energy, you meet people who are on your frequency. You meet people who actually do accept and love you and who will clap for you and are happy for you. Along this way, you could be meeting your life partner. But I just get like, again, it's going back to that official energy. You're moving into like an official state in your life. So I feel like the place that you've been in prior to this has been like a trial run. Like it's been a temporary place. And it doesn't matter how long, you could have been there for 50 years. but it was temporary. Where you're about to go now is where you're meant to be for the rest of your life. This is what's meant for you. This is your permanent position. So as I said before, whether it be a legally binding contract you're entering to, or it's just that you're going into a new state in life that is official, that you're not going to be able to turn back from, like, this is where you're cemented. This is where you're, you know, planting your seeds. It's working out in one way or the other. But yeah, this is official. It's official for you. Life is never going to be the same after this. You're not going to be able to turn back. No one is going to be able to take this from you, whether it be an official contract or, like I said, just the blessings starting to roll in now. And you do have a lot of blessings. You're going to be feeling like you're on top of the world. It's going to feel like there is so much coming at you at once that you're not even going to know what to do with it. I'm getting like someone, they have so much money, they don't know what to do with it. That could be a message for some of you. Some of you are going to be like having so many riches, like money just coming in from like left and right. Some of you could actually in your lifetime be reaching billionaires, multi-billionaire status. That's how like how blessed you're about to be. And when I say billionaire, I don't mean like 1 or 2 billion. I'm getting like 10, 20, 50 billion dollar worth I'm picking up here for somebody. Like, your blessings are tremendous. This is why the people are going to be hating on you the way they are, because like I said, they can't even try to compete. They can't even like attempt it. Like, no, if they want, because they were so used to like, okay, they have this, I can go get this. Like, if you have a nice car, they'll go get a better car. If you have, you know, a certain job, they'll go try to get a higher position. It's like whatever you were getting, they were able to like get more or have you in a position where you can still, where you still looked up to them or depended on them. But it's like you've exceeded everything that they could ever hope to reach in life. So now it's just like, you know, it's like they're just hating now, you know. I'm hearing hissing. So yeah, it's like they're a venomous tongue. Like, they're going to be saying very mean things to you, making you try to make you feel bad about yourself. Like I said, for some of you, it may like get to you here and there, but you can't allow that. I don't feel like it's going to break you, but I feel like there are going to be some times where you just kind of like, you know, really get down about like the things they're saying. And you might even start to question like whether what they're saying is true. I feel like you're going to come out of it, but there may be moments where you start to doubt yourself. And like I said, may even try to forfeit some of your blessings because you're like, I don't want to be hated like this. They might even try to make you feel like you owe them something and you don't, especially with the way they're coming at you. Like, if they had a good heart and were happy for you, you would have no problem like extending a helping hand and inviting them around and having them be a part of your blessing. But that's not what's happening here. It's like they have their hand out like, give me. They feel entitled to what you have, but then they're like cursing you at the same time. That's the energy I'm getting here. This person is awful. And you didn't know, or at least you didn't see it. Like, you put the blinders on to this person, like I said, because of how they showed up for you in the past. You thought they really had your back. But again, I'm hearing no worries, because you're gonna be exactly where you're about to go, into a place of acceptance. As much as you're about to have, you're going to have people around you who, they aren't going to be vultures. They aren't going to be just around because of what you have. Like, they really are on your level. And these people, when I said like on your level, they could have what you have. They could be just as successful and abundant as you are. So they don't need you for anything. They're just your friend, or they love you because they genuinely do, because you all are on the same frequency, you vibe on the same level, you understand each other. I'm hearing you have the same sense of humor. For some of you, this could be a relationship that's coming in for you. Like, you're finding your true soulmate, you're finding the person, your true divine counterpart, someone who gets you on every level. I'm also getting a message now that the person who could be attacking you could be a person that you were in a romantic relationship with, like your boyfriend or girlfriend. and like you thought this person has your back, and maybe they have in the past, but like I said, this person was secretly like hating on you the whole time. You had a partner, for some of you, romantic partner, who was jealous of you the whole time you've been in a relationship with them. And now that you're about to receive this blessing, now that you are receiving this blessing, it's like the person's true colors are showing, and you're having to end that relationship and you're walking away. So you're single and you're learning to be okay with that, but you end up going into another, like you end up running into like the love of your life, like your true divine counterpart, someone who is complete opposite of the mess you just left. So yeah, it's like if this is a love relationship you're going in, like if you're leaving one love relationship to go into another, you're going into a relationship with someone who truly gets you, who supports you, who claps for you, who is on your level and doesn't need you for anything. Neither are they trying to compete with you. Like they actually want to bring, like this could be someone who actually wants to bring you up in life. So if as much as you're about to be blessed, this person could be a part of the blessing for you. Like they could be blessing you with some of what you're about to get because they want to bring you up. They want an equal partner. And I feel like the person you were with in the past, they didn't want that. They just wanted you to be beneath them. And I feel like the person you were with in the past, they feel like they felt good about being with you as long as you were beneath them, you had less than them, that you depended on them. But this person you're about to be with now, this is your story. They want a partner. They want to bring you along for the ride. They want to, you know, what they have, when they eat, you eat. They want to, you know, when they get some sort of accolade, they want you to be in on it. They want you to succeed, to be your self as much as they are their best selves. So like you end up being an amazing team. But I feel like along with this person, if this is a love relationship, it comes like a whole like group of people who are also going to be in the celebratory energy with you, who are also on your level. And they won't be looking to use you. They won't be looking down on you. Like I said, they aren't vultures. They aren't going to be, you know, just trying to see what they can get out of you or just around you because of the clout or anything like that. Like they are genuinely, everybody that you're about to be around in this new life, they are genuinely on your level in any, on every level and every way, especially energetically. So yeah, you're going toward your soul tribe. I feel like I just did a reading about that. I think it was one of the Zodiac readings. But yeah. That's what all I have for you all for this filming and general energy reading. I hope it was helpful. Again, if you would like to check out your monthly zodiac readings or your general forecast for the rest of the year, or your love forecast for the rest of the year, you can do so at the Vimeo links below in the description box. If you would like to book a personal reading with me, link to the website can be found in the description box as well. And follow me on Instagram at Serene Dream Things for guidance. And I'll be back with more readings, lovelies. Bye.